I just want to show what's happened since I started watering the house plants with my clean water fun chlorine filter. Mushrooms are growing in my pot. There's more to come. Look at all the little babies. I'm a super sensitive human, and welcome to my garden. My garden is one of the happiest things in my life. I'm always out here inspecting the plants and designing in my head. And today I'm going to show you some of my favorite spring blooms. It's mid-spring in Arizona. It's May, early May. Cinco de Mayo, and some of the blooms, like the fruit trees, this guy already done, but other things have not even started yet. Bloom number one is this mallow here. I don't exactly know what it's called beyond that. It's a native desert plant that will reseed itself, and this one probably grew in the dirt from this cactus that I transplanted. But you see, it's quite large and lovely colored. Bloom number two, the Angelita daisy. These are new to my garden. I bought these, so I'm not sure what it's going to do, but it supposedly blooms year round. This is also a Southwest native. I'm not sure if it's the same yellow flowers you see out in the desert here or from a different part of the Southwest, but I'm encouraged by the promise of year-round blooms, and of course it's drought tolerant. Bloom number three, the autumn sage, Salvia greggii. These are native to West Texas and other parts of the Southwest, but not here. But they grow excellently here. No water, like those other two I just showed you. And they come in many different colors. Here's a fuchsia. And here's a purple one. So I love these. Bloom number four is irises. These are often planted here in the central part of the state. They do grow without water, but they'll grow bigger with water, such as mine have, a soaker hose down at the base. For bloom number five, behind me we have this trumpet flower. Sorry, I don't know what the name is beyond that. It's an evergreen trumpet flower. And it blooms here in springtime. Can't remember if it puts off a second bloom. It makes a really nice backdrop here for the irises along the fence, and it's slowly spreading, filling in. Doesn't really make a great fence cover because it just doesn't have enough leaves. Maybe someday. Nothing like the grapes, which will block off the view through a fence in a year. But I love the tropical look of a trumpet flower. And I'm not certain what the water status is on these. I bought them in Phoenix, so it's probably low water, but it's planted in my garden in this soaker hose bed. Bloom number six. I'm gonna pick one out of left field. These, you can hardly tell, are even a flower. They just blend right in with the bush, but this is a native goji berry with these delicate, lovely little bells. And uh, You can see we've got more trumpet vine growing in the shade, giving everything a nice jungly look. Number seven, how about these weedy bindweeds, morning glories? I don't know what they are exactly, but look at how nice of a ground cover they make if they get enough shade. But you have to pull them back from the other plants like so, or they will overtake it and start growing up it. That's the main problem. One like the vinca here, this ground cover won't really start twining up your plants and choke them out, but these guys will, and they'll grow all over where you don't want them to and be less lush and nice like these ones in the pathway. But for now I'm just leaving them here in this bed because I like the way they look. Number eight, snapdragons. I do water my snapdragons. These are a popular desert plant that will grow without water once established, but less lush. These are great year-round bloomers, almost year-round. They're one of the first things to start up and one of the last things to die out, and they go through some phases, but provide fairly long-lasting color. And have some other smaller ones, white ones, a red and yellow one back here. But the pinks seem to be doing the best. Bloom number nine. Back here we have the Mexican primrose. These are a no water, low water, self-seeding plant that the first year, I spread a bunch of seeds here under the porch. The first year one flower grew, and the next year a bunch more grew, and now the next year a bunch more are growing. So these are spreading themselves and crawling out from underneath the walkway out into the sun, which I don't mind because I like them. And some people hate these because they're weedy and takeover, but I don't think that that's going to happen here. Spring bloom number 10, we're going to go with the pyracantha here. This is amazing because it attracts a lot of bees and flies and other insects. The whole bush will be just buzzing with bees. These are low water, no water bushes, very popular in the area. Mine gets only a small amount of water and it's very lush and green. This one's doing a lot better than the other one though. This one that's in a bit of a hotter, drier spot, not doing quite so well. So that concludes the mid spring bloom tour of my garden. Stay tuned and perhaps I'll do a late spring tour. All the plants I just showed you are low water plants that thrive in the desert. So let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and let me know what your favorite spring bloom plant is in your garden. Mm-hmm.